our lizard girl. To get us started, can we get the word of something you'd like to see a show about?
Pizza.
Pizza?
We actually have another word. Sorry, we literally warmed up on that word.
We want a show about pizza.
Yeah.
Another word.
Furniture.
Bonfire.
I heard furniture.
Furniture, thank you. No shade on pizza, I'm sorry.
Oh, we know furniture. Sit on it, sleep in it, rest things on it. There's lots of things you can do with furniture.
Yeah, and you start out with IKEA furniture and like furniture that you find for free on the street. And then like once you hit a new job, you get to finally buy the first piece of furniture you don't have to put together on your own.
It becomes more durable, if you know what I mean.
I used to be an indoor rocking chair, but you know, I've been around for so long that they just got nicer things inside, like a recliner, and now I have to be on the porch in the cold.
I used to be a brand new off-the-shelf recliner, and now I've been sat in for a week.
Fuck you, recliner!
I have been making cabinets for 100 years. That's right, I'm 100 years old, and I've been making them since age zero. Granted, the cabinets I made at age zero were mostly made of spit.
I'm 100 years old and I've done nothing.
Well. So our second date was at Pottery Barn, and right then and there, I was just like, do you want to move in?
Oh, what did he say? What did he say?
He said no.
That's it. He said no.
Oh, and so you're not going to see
like,
it?
Oh, no.
Oh, I'm so sorry for your
breakup. Thank you so much.
Listen, all I'm saying is, if I find a mattress on the street, it's coming home with me, okay? It's not that weird, all right?
What if it's this small, though? What are you gonna do with the mattress this small?
I'm not as tall as you, okay? I'm not built like a giraffe, thank you very much.
This is a half of a cot.
You know what? I sleep little. I curl up like a little ball. That's how I like to rest, and this is where I want to slumber. Thank you for helping me bring it home.
Furniture!
I found it on the street. Can't even tell, can you?
I love it. It's gonna go great. I like that our motif is poverty.
Okay, you're saying you love it, but your tone says otherwise.
Yeah, that was intentional.
Well, it's a fixer-upper, you know? I can finally get out my paintbrushes, we can do some
Jenny,
jazz cheek, I can distress it.
Jenny, I think we should talk about our employment. Like, getting it. Like, I don't like calling your mother every month and asking her for money. I don't like that I have to call your mother every month to ask her for money.
We have issues, okay?
We both have liberal arts degrees. This was before the recession. This would not be a problem.
Yeah, well, it's not before the recession, and I try to make the best of a bad situation, okay, Greg?
Sorry.
How's my mother?
She's not great, if I can be honest.
Yeah,
pneumonia really took her for a ride.
Jesus, you didn't even tell me.
Well, you didn't want to know. Every time I'm like, oh, your mother, you're like, don't even with her.
I don't want to hear about it if she's complaining that we're not married yet, but I do want to hear about it if she has a possibly deadly illness.
She had a lung removed.
What the fuck?
But she managed to sneak in, have you proposed yet?
Of course she did. That's exactly like her. Never mind. Forget about that. I don't care. She's fine. Her lung's fine. Let's stop talking about her.
It was also the kidney.
A kidney?
Two, technically.
No, you need at least...
Oh, she had kidney failure. And the pneumonia.
Oh my god, Greg.
Bring, 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 bring. Oh. Hello?
Hi.
Is that my mother?
You want it on speakerphone?
No, I can't even.
Don't put her on speakerphone. Well, I can't talk to my daughter, you know that.
I really feel like in your weakened state and our poverty, it's time that you guys mend the fence a little bit, you know?
I can't talk to her not since she moved.
Mrs. Johannes? I'm gonna put my foot down because I've got to do something with my life because I'm so unbelievably bored. I'm gonna mend your relationship.
No.
I'm gonna mend your relationship.
I can hear everything you're saying.
How does the new chair look?
I can't believe it. It looks just like the one I broke.
Okay. This is my first classroom and my first job, Dad, and I had to buy this chair on my own. So if you could not break it, just like don't sit down.
I'm so sorry, sweetheart. Okay, I won't touch
it. Just put it against the chalkboard.
Oh my God, I'm so proud of you. So this is the whole space? This is the new classroom?
Yeah, this is the new classroom. I think the second graders are going to be like, wow, what a cool teacher.
I don't think so, but that's not like you. That's not as important, okay? When I taught Algebra 2, okay, I was cool and nobody learned anything, okay?
Dad, I'm not going to teach the second graders Algebra 2. That was like a million years ago. No one even takes algebra anymore.
But, okay.
It's true.
I'm sorry. I'm just saying, I don't want you to repeat my mistakes as a failed teacher, okay? I see myself in you.
Am I like an equation? Algebra is, right?
I was horrible at algebra. Don't you remember? I was terrible.
No. Dad, I'm just like, I'm so glad that you're here and you're able to like come to the first parent teacher night when all the kids are gonna come in and like,
can I write on the board or something? Just like,
sure, you can write on the board a special message for me.
Just like welcome. I do cursive still, sorry.
Just don't read cursive anymore.
Okay, a screw just fell out of the whiteboard, and that was not my fault.
Dad, this is a smart board. This costs like $3,000.
Okay, just get, is there tape around here?
No, people don't use tape anymore, Dad.
Well.
What do you think, I have some sticky tape?
I'm just saying, your classroom's falling apart, and you're blaming me, but it's cheap garbage nowadays.
My classroom is cheap garbage?
Yeah, you can't support my butt on that chair, and can't even, I touch the whiteboard, it breaks.
You know what, Dad? This is just like you. You're always tearing me down. This is my first job. You're just gonna have to stand there all night and hold your hand there while the parents come in. And if people ask if you're my boyfriend, I swear to God, you better say no.
Listen, Nick. I wanted you both here because the reason I gave you both keys to my apartment is I think you guys should move in with me.
You want us, your best friends who is a couple, to move in with you, a single guy. Why? We love you. John, we love you, but
you only have one bedroom, so like you would have to sleep on the couch and
every night
in the room. Meg, James, I thought you guys would ask that. The reason is because I feel like you guys need me, and I definitely need you guys. A lot. We've been going really good. Like, the relationship
is good. We've had a really nice 3 months. We miss you,
right,
and your
right.
humor, and your fun, but we've
We went to
really
Jacksonville for the weekend.
It was
so
like really
we tried a 3 month period of not hanging out.
The thing, Meg, I want you guys to remember is right now you're in what is called a honeymoon phase.
We've been together for
3 years. We wrote messages to each other in the sand.
No. I mean a honeymoon phase of your life without me.
It said love, and then I had our names under it in the sand. There was like a sunset.
I surrounded the love with a heart. We're like double the love.
This is so beautiful. What I want to say is that, like all honey, it will rot. It will go bad. See, like, this is fun. This is fun. Think about it. Just like imagine, like, you guys have a reservation at a restaurant.
Table
we did that
restaurant
in Jacksonville!
Billy's on the beach!
God, I can just imagine
hold
now
up.
We're sitting there
hold
at the
up.
Restaurant.
Meg has to work late. Uh-oh. What do you do? Buddy, we live together.
I would just come to the restaurant.
I would just bring food to where you work, and I would just sit in your office.
Honeymoon phase.
Okay. Rot, okay? I bring wine in a thermos.
It seems like he doesn't want us to be happy.
No, I do. It's just three's company, okay? And all I'm saying is, think about it, okay? My apartment is so much bigger than it looks.
Where would you sleep? Can we go back to that?
I have a king size bed. This isn't that weird, guys.
You dirty couch potatoes. Are you gonna get off the couch? Huh? I'm opening the blinds. All right, I'm opening them.
No.
Hell yeah, I'm opening them, you know.
Hurts my skin.
And you brought all your friends. You guys are all bums, you know that.
Dad, the sun makes me feel like I can't breathe.
Mr. Smith, your kids paid me to be here.
Well, at least someone has a job.
I had a job once at the 7-Eleven, but I got fired because I stole too many buffalo chicken taquitos.
I remember that summer.
You guys need to get out of my basement and go see the world, okay? You've been down here for 2 weeks straight.
Listen, I work in a mine, which is basically like living like this. So I'm gonna stick to that.
Oh, my basement is a mine, wow.
Yeah, when you have the shades down.
Mr. Smith, I just got back from like around the world travels with like my trust fund. I've seen the world. I'm fine.
You can see the world on the internet now. It's like just as good in HD.
We were actually reviewing my photos.
Yeah.
We're an eclectic group of friends.
Yeah, we've been over.
I got the hose. I didn't want it to come to this, but I got the hose.
What's that for, Dad?
I'm gonna start squirting you in the face.
What?
Shh.
Whoa!
So go ahead and do it. She's been calling you on the phone. She's been telling you to do it. You guys are really good friends now, right? So like, you're gonna get down on one knee, and I'm gonna cry. I'm gonna say yes. We're gonna do that whole thing, even though we have liberal arts degrees that tell us that marriage really is an institution that comes from, you know, like a sexist patriarchal society or whatever.
I want to break up.
Oh, I did not see that coming.
Yeah. Look. So you know how we've been spending a lot of time at home because of our unemployment.
Yeah.
Well, I've been going to the grocery store too sometimes, and I met someone there.
I'm sorry.
You want to pay for bags?
No. Hey, Crystal. You know how we've been hanging out a lot? I was just thinking that. Do you want to go out on a date?
I get off at 6.
Cool, I don't have anything to do. That'll work out really well. Cool, so I'll pick you up on the bus.
So you have a date with her tonight.
Yeah.
That's what you're saying. Like you're breaking up with me and going out on a date with her the same night.
And so Mrs. Johannes, with her one lung, went on to exact revenge on Greg, the bearer of bad news and a cheating scoundrel. It's been a while, huh? You look great.
Don't mind him. 1974, and it's my first geometry class. Wow, you students look like you're gonna be fun. Here's the thing about geometry. It's about ideas, okay? We all have them.
I thought this was algebra 2.
Oh. Okay, yeah, this is algebra 2. And it's another, that's also an idea. That's good.
Are we in the chairs because of funding? My mom said it was because of
funding. I took out the chairs because I wanted it to be more open.
How come he gets a chair?
Well, he's the dunce.
What?
I just mess it. I bust chops.
Can you teach us how letters are numbers?
Okay, forget the books. Everyone open the windows. We're throwing the books out, okay? All right, and you too, dunce, okay? We don't need books. Algebra's everywhere, okay?
Damn. You never told me Dead Poets Society was based on you.
Yeah, they made it about, whatever, Robin Williams, okay? But he's dead now, and I'm still alive.
I too will do a book.
Oh, my sweetie, my sweetheart, my baby, my captain.
My captain, that's right. Thank you.
I didn't
see it. You know, I get it, everybody's really inspired by the new teacher and whatnot, but I just feel like I'm getting bullied. And I don't know what to do about it. I haven't learned anything.
X squared plus Y squared equals 4.
Shut
you
up.
You can't answer the question?
Shut up, Jeremy. Okay, I don't need it from you, too.
You are the
I got
dunce.
The teacher calling me a dunce.
Sam, saying, you left your dunce cap in the principal's office. There you go.
Sam, listen, man. Two
the
things.
Principal's in on it.
You get to sit down, and you get to wear an awesome hat every day, all
yeah,
right?
That's great.
Shut it!
No, I'm not going to shut it, because you guys get to stand and work, which is apparently good for your health. I have to sit down and develop pain in my knees. I guess. I don't know, I'm dumb, apparently.
This is your former student.
What?
Preacher, go ahead. Save me, preacher.
Oh my God.
Why are you
in
a
house? You guys,
why did you sound like an owl?
That's the sound I make when I sleep. Usually I dream of birds, and then I then become it kind of.
I don't want to hear about your birds! Why are you in a
house? Oh, you know what? Adam sent me. He said you guys, you kind of sent me as a scout.
You mean John? He goes by Adam with his friends, I think.
John?
Why did he send me? Why did he send me? I was a scout. What is he scouting?
He told me to see what kind of space you guys have, so I've been staying up in your attic.
Are you kidding me?
Were you there before we went to sleep? You know.
Yeah, I've been up there for about a week.
There's so how'd it go? How'd it go? I need some feedback.
I'll tell you what, there is plenty of space for the both of us. Which, by the way, you told me your name was Adam. Basically, your name was John.
That is actually a compliment. I tell people my name is John when we're in the honeymoon
phase. Can't sleep. They're arguing about the name thing again.
I just can't stop thinking about the fact that he saw us have sex. Like, a lot. And now he's out there with our friend. That doesn't bother you?
It bothers me more that I can't get any sleep, and I keep hearing them talking about names, and I can hear them like...
Nice to meet you. You saw them the moment I was... conceived?
Yeah. You know, I don't believe there's
Pottery Barn auditions? You think you want to be an associate here?
Let's see it. Hey, this is the most strict, well-run Pottery Barn you're ever going to find. We don't take any shit from our employees.
You think they call this Tyson's Corner because it's just a corner?
No, it's at the center of the world now, baby.
I would just like to say that I am a top sales associate at CB2, so I think I would make you really proud. Thank you for listening.
I would just like to say that I'm a longtime customer, and I think that sets me apart from the regular customer. That's all I want to say.
I brought my own cash register.
Oh, and, what are you too?
Now I just feel like an idiot.
Well done, gentlemen.
Do you think
we hire people who don't come with registers?
Probably not.
Get in here. Start ringing this rich lady up.
I can't open it because it's from the CVS thing store.
Yours too?
I did not have to provide my own register at CB2. I just want to put that out.
I found the CVS next door.
What?
I'm kind of looking for a lamp.
What'd you say?
Perfect opportunity. A man looking for
Let's
a lamp.
Oh, why sign up for a lamp when you can have a cash register?
I can't understand his accent. I don't know what he said about the CVS.
I worked there.
I didn't realize that you were role playing in the interview.
Neither did I.
Sorry, my name is Richard. I don't have any sales experience, but I love Pottery Barn so much that I made a song about it for you guys, and I'm gonna sing it to you now.
Oh, Pottery Barn, Pottery Barn, the best kind of barn is a Pottery Barn.
What a jingle!
Actually pretty good.
My dad formed Pottery Barn in his barn 40 years ago.
Oh my god. It's fake. This is fake.
He was watching Ghost where they did the pottery and then he died, so I'm upset.
Thank
you. So I feel like you're...
How much is this one?
Can someone help this guy?
I'm not. I'm like...
Okay, honey. Are you sure you locked the windows? Before we go to sleep, I just like can't sleep if I feel like
yes. I turned off the stove, I locked the windows, okay. I made sure the front door was closed. It's still pigeons. It's a city. There's pigeons.
Whoa.
What the fuck?
What? What's happening again?
It's a window extrovert. I've heard about him. There's been news articles and blog articles and email listserv articles.
I tried to check to see if you guys had an attic, but I just came in straight through the skylight.
I didn't even know that was a possibility. I'm
what?
Sorry. I don't even have locks on the skylight.
Jesus.
Sorry, I make bird sounds.
Goddamn recliner, millennial, stop talking. I'm trying to enjoy some peace and quiet on this porch.
I just think that it's really important to get in touch with your emotions, you know? And, like, if we have a problem with each other, we can talk it out. The window's open. It's a perfect opportunity.
I liked it better in 1974 when no one knew how to talk. We just sat and enjoyed the silence.
All right, porch chair, but, like, what is your personality type, for instance?
Quiet and old.
Well... I mean, I'm an adventurer, so that means that, like, I like to do new things, but I also respect when things just happen to me.
Hello, old friend.
Look, we each got
yes,
one.
I'm on this thing.
Oh, yours goes back?
It does now.
No, I go back. I'm a recliner. No, sit back down.
I just think this is the right mattress for me, okay? All right.
Tiny fucking
okay.
Clock.
You know what? I'm done with this.
I know.
Hey.
Hey. Some woman said, and we should get back. I'm your old ex-boyfriend.
And so her revenge exacting went a little slow at first.
What's your idea?
Here I am in the knife aisle of this CB2. Me and knives. It's already building up for it.
And these are our best knives. They're sharp.
Wow. That was really rich new job and a great girlfriend.
All he does is just hit on women who are in sales positions.
This one is orange.
Oh, that's great. I know, Jake.
Go
one
tell
of
her,
my last remaining ribs.
Her.
And I'm gonna pull it out of my chest.
And tell her your mother.
And I'm
she'll hate that.
Stab him, though. I'm just gonna
I'm
stab
sorry,
him.
I'm sorry, can I help you with something?
Oh my god! Ah! Oh. Ah!
Ah! Algebra, wow. You can't spell it without bra. You heard me, ladies. Burn it!
Hey, he's in the Dutch chair. He's in the
dunce chair, right? It's not me anymore, right?
We trade off, okay?
I'm just keeping the seat warm for you.
Oh, now, like I said, algae bra, we're burning our bras today! Yes! Did you bring yours, or are you the dunce again?
I haven't developed it.
Are you sure we should put the fire in the school?
Thank you, yes, sir. Chef.
From the audience.
Bowling alley.
Bowling alley, thank you.
Over here we see an 8th grade field trip. They're in Washington, D.C. for the first time, and they're all hormonal and excited.
Oh boy, I can't wait to roll this ball down the aisle.
We see all of the lanes have extra tall bumpers. We don't even know how they got extra tall bumpers, but they are ready to throw those balls.
I'm gonna show Caroline how strong I am.
I don't want to roll my bowling ball. I just want to hold it.
My name says ass on the screen.
Mine says double ass.
Do you see my ball?
I managed to make it over the bumper. Is that what I was supposed to do?
We see a bowling alley employee surreptitiously taking drinks of beer at the bar.
We see someone under the counter smoking some weed.
We see a third employee surreptitiously stealing cash from the register.
We see a fourth employee who just is taking all the nachos.
We see a fifth employee who is surreptitiously popping the popcorn directly into his backpack.
My mom always said hard work was the key to success, but I'm pretty sure it's just larceny.
Is this a 9 or a 6?
Well, you want a beer?
Yep, here you go.
These only cost like 50 cents to make.
This is even less, trust me.
We see a parent feverishly trying to beat the top score on Frogger.
Just one more game.
I used to be so good at this as a teenager. What happened?
I swear to God, something's wrong with these buttons.
Who's this ass kid?
The token machine has been knocked over and kicked, obviously.
What do you mean, two?
Jump over the river, not into it, dumbass.
No, it's a truck.
Kid doesn't get into Stanford, I'm jumping off a bridge.
I'm already so stressed out just thinking about it.
Quit the job. I'm sorry to tell you, I buried the lead, but I quit my job. I gotta get that kid into Stanford. I was a little shit. I didn't do good in college.
I ran over the cat today.
No, weasels, no.
I was playing the Stanford fight song too loudly in the car, and I didn't hear the noise when the tires drove over it.
Oh, sweetie, why didn't we coordinate our plan to get our kid into Stanford? No. We both just did real dumb things, and he's an idiot. He's not gonna get in the stairs. We gotta.
Ding dong!
I don't wanna get the door. You think it'll be the cat?
What if it's a Stanford rep saying that he didn't get in?
Is they come to doors now? No, do I look okay?
Yeah, I look great.
Wait, he's got files in his bag.
Oh, no, 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 don't open the door. I'm not wearing my crimson sweater.
Okay, your crimson
sweater. Okay.
Hello.
U.S. Postal Service, we make door calls now.
Thank
Take
you.
Care.
That's sweet. It was just a postal service man. This is a real important package.
Oh, no, it's just a little envelope.
It is. It's a little... Little 2x2! I can't open it.
Okay, I'm gonna open
Wait,
it.
It says his name, it's a federal offense.
We're his parents, Cindy!
Oh, that's right.
He's 17! It says, oh god, I'm already crying, I can't read, you gotta read it for me.
Oh my, the spirit is dripping down my face.
Oh no! It says we tampered with a Stanford application, and they can tell because we signed the application Barb and Cindy.
Doing the right thing never got anyone anywhere.
Yeah, man, fuck this place. Fuck the bowling alley, you know? Just, if you know what, you know what? If I could get away with it, I just set fire to it. Burn it down.
Got a lighter.
Go for it. Destroy this place.
Yeah, fuck this summer job, right? You know, like, I'm not getting into any good colleges or anything, right, man?
Peters is riding my fucking ass.
Yeah,
every
day in, day out, yeah, yeah. Fuck him.
I love watching this place burn.
Yeah. Do you guys want to do it with me? Do you guys want to put a hand on it?
It's your time to shine.
Yeah, well, before I do, I'm going to say a few words. I'd like to extend this conversation. I feel like it's the first time we've bonded. So, like, you guys are, what, you're like 50?
Been here a long time. 52.
Oh, hey, I heard we were finally burning this place. I got some oil that you put down the alleyway, so just get this going. Yeah, just throw the fire on the oil here anytime. As soon as you're ready, just dump the lighter right in the oil. It'll go up in flames real fast. Hey, you're a real champion.
Oh, thanks, Chad. Now he's implicated, too. Your DNA's on that? All right. That's fine. Now we're all in this together. Before it was just me, and I was like, oh, I don't want to go to jail. But now if I got you guys as bunkmates...
I feel like you're just avoiding doing
it. I'm sorry, I'm a little scared, you know? The only thing I set fire to was the forest in, like ninth grade?
Just an accident.
Yeah.
Even though you took credit for it later.
You know what, man? I got Sarah's number out of it. You weren't gonna get Sarah's number, but I did.
You need to take control of your life. I want to see you destroy something on purpose. You don't get to just take credit for accidents that happen. Look at me, I'm a badass. Still dating Sarah.
Wait,
a little pissed about that.
I'm going to stop you right there. Carl, it's real tempting for me to throw this cigarette into this old...
Then go for it! That was my whole thing. We should
this
all...
This is you. Fuck. This is your time.
All right.
Was that a... You know, it's not... It's a lighter.
Got the assault rifle.
I don't really know how this game works, and I keep trying to pick up the things, and I just seem to walk through them.
Rebecca, your pack's full.
Wait, what?
Inventory pack is full.
Is that a good thing?
If you press square, you can switch to a different item in your inventory and use that. Look, you're my little brother. I want to teach you these things, but I don't think I'm getting anywhere with this.
Right. Square. Okay, see, I keep trying to move him around, and I just, and but things keep dying around me. Is that how that's supposed to be? I don't.
Oh, you're kicking my ass. Oh, awesome job. Oh. You got me. That was the one thing I had left. You're going to college. You're about to outpace me in every way in life. And well, you outpace me in this game, too. Call of Duty Modern Warfare.
Look, Jack, just because I'm going to college at 16 and you haven't yet made it into college at 25 doesn't mean that I'm better than you. This was just beginner's luck, right?
It's not that I think you're better than me. I'm a perfectly accomplished mechanic at the local auto shop. I'm gonna miss you, man.
I'm gonna miss you too, but I am not going to college far away. I'm not allowed to at 16. They sort of like are keeping me close.
No, you'll be at the perfectly accomplished local trade college, learning to be a mechanic. But a real good one.
What's happening?
Oh, if you get an act to try to connect with someone, they just come back to life.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Well, look, you're a great brother, and I'm only going to trade school to be like you. You know, I just thought it'd be really great if we could be in the same profession. And look, I'm not so good at the games, or maybe I am kind of good at the games, but
great.
It's only because you taught me.
I'm awesome. I'm kicking my ass.
Everyone blows a 300 every time.
There's no separation anymore. Like, we're just basically the same person.
Good sound effects, guys.
Yeah.
No, okay.
I thought that was, like, part of our superstition. So I bowl 300 every time.
Dude, have you ever tried bowling without sound effects? You won't get 300 anymore.
Steve, right?
See, watch. I'll try to bowl without the sound effect.
Wait, what?
No!
Sorry, I was trying to make a point, but okay.
I had your back.
Don't do it.
I gotta see, though.
No.
Look, maybe we're less comfortable with change than we thought we were, okay? This is a perfectly good bowling alley.
You guys, I'm a philosophy major. Steven, there's been some news from Stanford.
News?
Yeah.
What kind of news?
Why don't we sit down on the ground?
That's good news, right?
Yeah, let's sit down, sweetie.
Don't tell her! Him!
Baby, you didn't get in. You know, they reviewed your application and they thought, you know, there's a lot of applicants this year and it was really hard for them. Also, your mother and I changed your application and plagiarized some work and signed it with our own names instead of yours, so they knew that it was
okay, changed. Give her a moment to react before you just lay all the frick out there, jeez louise. Let her look.
You know I feel guilt at an extreme level.
<That's right. laughs>
give us 1 second, okay?
Did I not get in, or did you all not get in?
All three of us are not going to get in.
Okay, I'm gonna turn it up.
Okay, I'm with you. Three. I'm here, you two.
Yeah. One.
Oh, okay.
We were so nervous. We bought all the Crimson stuff. We learned the fight songs, and so we just thought that it felt like it was our application somehow.
I talked about when I was growing up, the hard time I went through, and I thought it was going to be a good college essay.
I talked about the time my horse Bess died in the county fair.
What about my college essay? What about the one that I wrote? Here I am raking up fake leaves to pay for my education at Sanford. And you didn't even see me the words that I submitted?
Sweetie, it's Stanford. I'm so sorry.
Man, I'm fucking sick of working at the stock exchange. This place is ridiculous. I mean, it's boring all the time. All the ticker tape everywhere.
I make so much money, I don't even care anymore.
I hate it all. Man, I wish I could just burn it to the ground.
I literally light my cigarettes with $100 bills. It's the only way you can get rid of all of it.
I don't know.
Don't trust the banks.
Don't trust the banks.
Hey, we're setting Wall Street on fire finally. Here, I just lit this match. Here you go, man. Good luck.
Dude, do it. Fuck this place.
Alexa, I just lost us $1 million.
Oh, wow. Oh, wow. I mean, I was thinking I was going to, like, maybe say a few words about this whole situation and the general conundrum.
Continue.
But if I lost $1 million, maybe we could, like, cancel the ticker tape. We just set them on fire now. Get the ticker tape. Get all the tapes around. Just set them on fire.
Those are all screens.
Oh, God, they got rid of the tape.
No one does this tape anymore.
How are we supposed to set Wall Street on fire? I want more than a metaphor!
I don't know. I mean, maybe like a computer virus or something.
Okay, is there like a fire that's a computer virus? I want there to be fire! We have to set Wall Street on fire!
Hey guys, I heard you wanted to do a virus to Wall Street, so I got you this memory stick that you can plug in and it'll blow up all the computers. Alright, good luck!
Brilliant. I fucking love our interns. They're amazing.
This is why we make so much money.
Yeah, so I'm just gonna need you to watch over my son. He needs help sometimes, and I just need anything he says he needs. I need you to enter the room like you weren't listening. And offer it to him. He wants a computer virus. If my son wants a fire, if my son wants a goddamn virus to blow this earth apart, you bring it in, and then you leave.
All right, guys, I mean, what we really need, I'm just tired of the U.S. government, man. The whole thing, we should just end it now. I mean, like, the Capitol building's pretty ugly. I don't know what you guys think. We just need something.
If there was just some way to completely get rid of the Capitol building.
Just like wipe it off the map.
The world's biggest wrecking ball.
The world's biggest wrecking ball. That would be perfect.
I heard you wanted to do something to the Capitol and you needed a really...
Oh my goodness. If only we had like a crane or something that we could use this wrecking ball with.
Are you fucking kidding me?
Because we'll pay you.
So you made it through college in 2 years. Mm-hmm. Very impressive.
I mean, it was technical college, but that's usually only a 2-year college.
Mm-hmm. Also, on your resume, you listed that can't go far from home. Could you tell me more about that, please? Because this job requires travel.
Oh, well, like, I'm willing to travel, but I don't have my driver's license yet. And my brother, Jack, he's really important to me, and I really don't like being too far away from him. I think that he helps me do better. So if I could bring him...
We do also need a receptionist. So yes, yes.
He can do that.
I'll just pencil that in for another interview. Great. Thank you.
I'm sorry to interrupt the interview, but this man broke down the door, and he literally has taken me hostage until I brought you to this interview.
No, Jack, come in, I got you a job!
Is this your brother?
Wait, no, you have to press square. That's not what you wanted to bring. Huh. Find something else in the backpack.
Look. Here there's a receptionist opening.
Well, assertive, aggressive, and psychic.
Yes.
Well, that's fast. I didn't even see it.
Take extreme measures when I hear something I kind of want, but not that much, but I want to fight for it anyway, like this receptionist position.
Well, we appreciate that here, the Humane Society, so...
Hired.
<Right.
laughs> You start tomorrow. great.
I mean, I know this isn't...
I
know it's not.
I don't know how you did it. I don't know how you did it. But you went to a technical college and got a degree for working with
animals.
I'm
sorry, we can
get it. It's so good. I could have never done that. I'm so proud of you.
Well, I'm proud of you. Look at you. You're a receptionist at the Humane Society.
That's right. So, when do I
start? Right here.
We cut to their first day on the job at the Humane Society.
Look, Jack, there's a puppy.
Hi, yes, I would like a puppy.
She wants a puppy.
We have a lot of different puppies. We have a whole kennel of puppies.
Receptionist will help you fill out all the forms that you need.
Perfect.
Go on.
The door says closed, but I'm...
I broke the door. That's why you were able to get in.
Fantastic. Good work, son. Ooh, puppy.
Yes. Thanks, Pete.
Yes.
Oh, hey. Hey.
Hey.
Hey. Oh, hey.
Hi.
Hi.
Hello.
Hi.
Hey. Hi there.
No, hey.
Hi.
I love networking. I've been in my job for 3 years now. Yeah, it's one place, 3 years. Whole 3 years, same place.
Eventually, I will actually cross into the office and say hi to people up close. Hey! Hey!
Hi. Is this where we poke people, too?
Oh.
Oh.
Hi.
Oh.
Hi.
Didn't know you could do that.
Oh, wow.
I designed spreadsheets.
Oh, I made this business card on Vistaprint.
Hey.
I can do PowerPoint really well.
I love meetings. I am great at conference calls. I always hit my mute button.
Oh.
I'm a people person.
I have a job.
I can hold a keyboard like this.
My chair spins in circles.
This is a key card. It's for the elevator.
Can I see the key card again?
Okay.
I have a key card now.
Listen. I found this man from Wall Street. He says that he has an intern that does anything he says whenever he asks. And I thought if we hire, you know, for our son, maybe he could get him into Stanford.
Okay, let's do it.
Watch this. Hey, get me into Stanford. Do it. Watch what happens. It's gonna be really great.
I heard somebody needed to get into Stanford. Here's
thank you. Thank
right
you.
There.
Oh my God! It's a 5-5-5! It's a 5-5-5!
I'm kind of afraid.
We're out of milk.
It doesn't matter, sweetie.
I'm gonna accept this letter to Stanford.
It's a 5-5-5.
Did you finally submit my application?
No, we
well,
still
it's,
did.
It's my application, but.
Overheard you needed some milk. Just brought it.
Thanks.
Highland Park Animal Shelter. Highland Park Animal Shelter.
Do you think they'll ever unpause the game?
Highland Park Animal Shelter, this is my personal hell.
Hey,
You've been a really great avatar, but it's time for me to move on.
What? I don't understand. I've got you more gamer score, more experience points. I have the sickest chrome armor. How could that possibly be?
Jack's tired of Call of Duty, so we're gonna play Crazy Taxi now.
Crazy Taxi! They don't have avatars in Crazy Taxi! This is an outrage! Don't you dare! Don't!
I can't believe they gave me this puppy.
God, sit down. You know what you've done.
I know what I've done.
We found your DNA in the oil. In the bowling alley. You burned down that AMC.
Burned it down.
You even hesitated for so long that someone came by and took pictures of you while you were doing it.
I've never been good at making decisions. And then when I finally tried to fucking burn it down, I just...
I can't believe they give you conjugal visits with Susan!
Yeah, well...
Do you think the Tama was an accident?
No, I mean...